Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I welcome you all in this video. You all know that the video is going to help you in your RBI 7 award examination. Along with this, if anyone of you who are coming here for the first time, so let me tell you that the questions that I discuss in this video can be of use if you are appearing for banking examination at the level of PU. So on that note, the newcomers, this is for you guys. Do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group where you can directly connect with your mentors, and we also provide free quizzes on that group. So you can enjoy those quizzes as well. This is the new course for RBI Gradebee 2022 that we have launched. In this course, you will get videos, PDFs and mocks. Along with this, we also conduct mock interviews. So you can also get yourself prepared for the final interviews of your RBI Gradebee exam. And along with this, you will get a book kit that will have all these books mentioned here on the screen. Along with this, we are running a 30% discount on this course right now. So if you want to avail that discount, you have to use RBI30 coupon code. And this is the mobile number which you can use if you have any queries related to the course eligibility or anything else. Then you can just call us on this number. So let's begin with this first question of the day. Which of the following statement is not true about PM CARES for Children scheme? So this is the new scheme that has been launched by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in order to help the children who have lost their parents due to the COVID pandemic or due to the COVID disease. Now let's say what are these statements or which one is not true about this PM CARES for Children scheme. First statement is PM CARES will contribute to through a specially designed scheme to create a corpus of Rs 10 lakh for each child when he or she reaches 18 years of age. Second is, the child will be given admission in any central government residential school such as Sainik School, Navodaya Vidyalaya, etc. If the child is admitted in a private school, the fees as per the RTE norms, RTE right to education, will be given from the PM CARES fund. All children will be enrolled as a beneficiary under Ayushman Bharat scheme with a health insurance cover of Rs 5 lakhs. So which one of these statements is not right? Actually, all of these statements are right. So here our right answer would be option E, that is none of the above. Now let us discuss some features of this PM CARES for Children scheme. But before beginning with the details, let me tell you that this PM CARES for Children scheme is a comprehensive scheme that is catering to different dimensions of a child's life. For example, it also has coverage for health insurance. It also includes the coverage, financial coverage for the child's education at the elementary level as well as at the level of higher education. So this is basically a comprehensive scheme which is catering to all the needs of the child. So now let's discuss the scheme in detail. The first detail here is that the student will get the benefit of having a fixed deposit in his name. So the child or the student will get Rs 10 lakh in his fixed deposit at the age of 18 years. So from 18 years onwards till the 5 years, from 18 years to till the coverage of 5 years, he will be given a monthly amount from this 10 lakh corpus so that he can use that amount for his personal requirements during the period of higher education. And after that, when he attains the age of 23, then the student or the child will get the entire remaining amount in lump sum so that he can use that amount in for his personal use or for his professional use. So either ways, whichever way he wants to use the fund, he can use it. The next is the next benefit that the children will get is that school education for children under 10 years will also be taken care of by the PM CARES fund. So first of all, the child will be given admission in the nearest Kendriya Vidyalaya or in a private school as a day schooler. So the child will be admitted to the school. And the second point here is that if the child is admitted to a private school, then the amount of the fees will be given from the PM CARES fund. Acha, PM CARES fund will also pay for the expenditure on uniform, textbooks and notebooks. So this is the overall coverage of a child's education at the level of elementary school under the years of 10 years. Okay. The next one is school education for children between 11 to 18 years, that is mid schooling or secondary school. So here the child will be given admission in any central government residential school such as Sainik School, Navodaya School, etc. The next point is, in case the child is living with his grandparents or his relative or his guardians, then the nearest Kendriya Vidyalaya will admit those students in the school. okay, or they can be admitted to the private school at the nearest location. Now, in case if the school is private, then the fees will be borne by the PM CARES Fund. And the next point here is that PM CARES Fund will also pay for the expenditure on uniform textbooks and notebooks. So that was for the secondary level students. The third benefit that the children will get is the support for their higher education. If the student is willing to pursue any professional course or any higher education course, then he will get a loan from the banks, and the interest in that loan will be paid by the PM CARES Fund. So that is first point here, that the interest on the loan will be paid by PM CARES Fund. The second point here is that these students who are obtaining the benefit of PM CARES Fund will also be eligible for the scholarships. So basically, they will continue to be availing the benefit of scholarships that they have been availing till the launch of this scheme and under the various central and state governments scheme. The third point here is that the children who are not eligible for existing scholarship schemes will be provided an equivalent scholarship through PM CARES Fund. So basically, this is saying that the children who are not covered under any scholarship scheme, who are not that much meritorious, or they are not availing any kind of benefit under any of these scholarship schemes, then those students will get benefit of the scholarship scheme, basically of the amount equivalent to the scholarship scheme from the PM CARES Fund. So that was the third benefit. And the fourth benefit here is the health insurance that the students will get. All the children will be enrolled as a beneficiary under Ayushman Bharat scheme with a health insurance of rupees 5 lakh, and the premium amount for these children till the age of 18 years will be paid by the PM CARES Fund. So that was all about this question. Now we are moving on to the next question. What is the GDP forecast for India for FY22 by OECD? So for the year FY22, the forecast is 9.9%, and it is basically a downgrade from 12%. 12 point something was the forecast made by OECD in the month of March, but now it has reduced it to 9.9% for this year. And for the entire globe, the forecast has been capped at 5.8% for this year. And this is an increase from the previous forecast. So for the entire globe, OECD has increased its forecast, but for India, it has decreased its forecast. So that was all about this question. There is nothing much that you can remember. Always remember, GDPs are to be remembered at the last moment. Okay, so on that note, I would like to ask a question from you. And that question is the headquarters of OECD. So you have to mention it in the comment section below. Next is, who has been appointed as the interim chief of the Central Board of Direct Taxes? So here we have Sadanand, Adam Mittal, V.D. Jaswani, J.P. Mahapatra, Vikas Shil, and out of these five options, the right answer is J.B. Mahapatra. Now, he has been appointed as the interim chief for 3 months. But CBDT is an important agency, and you should remember the chief of that organization. Next is, who is the president of CII for 2021 to 2022? So, the right answer here is option C, T.V. Narendra, who is at present the CEO and MD of Tata Steel. So this is again something that you should remember. So that was all for today, guys. I hope that you have learned something in this video. And if you have, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification. Thank you so much for watching the video.